Hey everybody, I hope you're all doing well. Here is my last video of 2019, and this is cringy as heck to say because I only posted 3 videos this year in total. So I'm keeping it short because I don't have a lot of new stuff to share, but I said before that I intend to build the habit of uploading a video once every month. My video editing skills are still non-existent, but at this point, building the habit's more important to me than producing something great. No space for perfectionism right now. If I don't force myself to make these simple videos, my channel is just gonna collect dust for another few years, so nah, this'll have to do for now. I wanted to make a very quick video about my art goals for 2020. As it is right now, December 2019, I'm working a full-time day job and a demanding one at that. I still come home pretty dead inside, and if I don't save myself from this job soon, I'm gonna die on the outside too. So I'm gonna put on a time lapse of one of my recent sketches in the background and just touch on my checklist of my most important art goals in 2020. In this list, I'm focusing only on the goals that directly feed into my art side business. Number 1. Improve my skill and speed in background painting. Even after all these years, I tend to feel a lot more comfortable drawing characters than drawing environments. I still want the bulk of my work to showcase strong character design and draftsmanship, but I also want to have just enough skill to create appealing backgrounds for these characters to exist in and become more a part of a world that feels real. And I hope to cut down the time it takes me to draw a single, simple to moderately complex environment to one day. Number 2 is consistent work. Granted, my day job obligations seep into after hours and often take over my weekends, but I'm making some adjustments to reduce my day job workload during the first half of next year. The minimum amount of work I'd like to achieve is 30 minutes working on my side business during the work days and a minimum of 10 hours during the weekends. At this point, I'm not very confident giving a solid number as to how many completed projects I want to finish every week. But just for the sake of saying something, I'll say one completed project a week is a success. This isn't realistic, but we'll keep it like that for now and not stress too much over it. I'm already suffering from anxiety. So, number 3, set up a dedicated social media account for my art business. That channel doesn't contain any of my personal art, obviously, and fan art will probably be kept to a minimum. This channel will be all about building a small brand, showcasing interesting projects, and sharing quality posts, such as little art tips and tricks and motivational posts to spark a conversation. I'm gonna start with only Instagram and build that properly. And once I'm happy with it, I'll be sure to share it with you as soon as possible. I've already planned the content for that account 3 months in advance. So the hard part is to stick to that. There should be 2 posts per week, and while it sounds easy in theory, it's a lot more work than I anticipated. Moving on before I get more anxious, number 4 is researching the art convention scene in my country and attend at least 2. This is a big one. I've only ever participated in one convention back in 2017. It was an anime convention, and while the event was a lot of fun, there were several problems with the chosen location of the event, and due to the fact that I had very little time to prepare enough work as prints, I could only take a few things with me. Basically, I said to myself, if I can just cover my expenses, just my expenses, I'll consider it a success. And that is exactly what ended up happening. The event was 8 hours long, and I only barely covered my expenses. No profits. It's been over 2 years since I participated in a convention, and I definitely need to be better prepared for it this time around with enough work and products that people will be interested to buy. This time, rather than only covering the expenses of participating in the convention, my goal is to make a profit of at least 50% of my expenses. So for example, if my expenses for the convention were $100, then I have to make at least $150. The last goal, number 5, is networking. Meeting other artists and learning from people who are already where I want to be, people who are making a decent income from their craft. I have absolutely no problem asking people questions, and I like to think that I can keep questions brief so I don't waste anybody's time. However, not everybody is open to answering questions. People's reasons vary. Some may have a good reason, I guess, not to share a lot of their experience, but others unfortunately seem to retain knowledge out of insecurity or a lack of confidence or fear of competition. It's a very unhealthy state of mind, but anyway, I hope I find people who are willing to teach me, if only for a few minutes. And in turn, I hope I become a good example of an artist people would want to learn from one day. So to summarize, my art goals in 2020 are 5. Number 1, improve my background painting. Number 2, work on my art more consistently, at the very least 30 minutes on the weekdays. Number 3, create a business Instagram channel for my art business. Number 4, take part in at least 2 art conventions in 2020. Number 5, meet other professionals and start a network with like-minded artists, online and offline. Alongside these goals, I'll still do my best to upload a video once every month, even if it's just a few minutes long. I'd like to make a video some other time talking about my experiences with creating a simple but effective marketing plan for my art business, but it's still too early for that. Marketing is one of these elements I'm most anxious about because I have no background in sales. But it's a skill I'm gonna have to learn sooner or later, and I assume somebody out there watching the videos will find it funny how I have no idea what I'm doing. So anyway, thank you so much for listening, guys, and until next time, please like and subscribe and tell me about your art goals for 2020. If there are any artists you recently discovered on YouTube, new artists especially, be sure to let me know about them so I can check them out. This could be a part of the networking goal I was talking about. Yeah, thank you so much again, and I wish you all a happy 2020. May all of our ambitions carry us, and may our goals come true. So, see you soon. Peace.